From the KDLM studios in Detroit Lakes, it's HodgePodge with Carol McCarthy, presented by Partnership for Health and now airing on TV3.
Today on HodgePodge, my guest is Becker County Administrator Mike Breathorst, and we're going to talk about some of the things going on in the county, some of the business going on, and as we head into the spring months, lots going on. Good morning, Mike.
Hey, good morning, Carol. It's good to be here. Thanks.
Yeah, well, glad you could join us. Now you've got a month under your belt here in the county as the administrator, and things are going, you're settling in a little bit more.
Yeah, the time has flown, that's for sure. This commission and the staff are keeping me busy and keeping me informed on what's going on. And it's a great organization that I fell into here. It's absolutely a pleasure to go into work every morning and just the welcoming atmosphere that I get here. So it's great.
Okay, good. So yeah, there is a lot going on. We've got the new jail, but now that the new jail is up and nearly running, I think they've started transporting inmates back and forth. But we've got the old stuff to contend with, namely minimum security jail. That's what I'm trying to say, and also the old kitchen equipment now.
Right. Yeah. So we do it. We have the old. Well, we have two facilities. Well, we actually have three facilities. You have the current jail that we have, and then which is fully operational, and we're working through all the things that go along with getting that operational, and Paula and her team and Sheriff Glander got that well under control. Mm-hmm. Now, what we have to do with, where I come into play now and the staff does, is we have these other assets now that we no longer need. And our commission has deemed that the minimum security facility, which was located right next to Lake Schertz, we don't need it anymore. So we want to get that back out onto the market. So the commission yesterday deemed that it was excess property. And so now we are going to be seeking qualifications for people to help us dispose of that asset. And so we hope to get that. Our plan is to have that on the market here by the third quarter of this year and get that back into the public, into the private sector, so they can use that facility somehow, some way. And so that's what this RFQ is going to help us do, is they're going to help us advise the commission on how to best utilize that to get that asset onto the market.
Okay. So,
and then some of the other little things that we have that have been deemed excess as well is in the sheriff's office, we no longer smell the cornbread and the great food that's been coming out of there over the years. So we've now have this kitchen equipment that we have, you know, so it's a standard commercial grade kitchen. We have refrigerators, freezers, steel, everything you can think of for a kitchen. Mm-hmm. And so we are going to get that out on the market as well, too. Okay. And so we'll be doing that through just some online auction that we have, that we've dealt with other things in the past. And that'll be coming up here as well as within the third quarter. We're in the second quarter now. So by July, we should see those things up on the market so people can get a chance to buy some of that. It's actually fairly good stuff.
Right.
And it's fed a lot of people over the years. And so that's something that we're working on right now. And okay. So the commission gave us the guidance and direction to do that. So we're moving forward.
All right. So the minimum security jail is on that same sort of timeline?
Yeah, that's what our goal is. We just decided yesterday to get it onto the market. So I have drafted up a request for proposals yesterday, last night. I stayed late, so the commissioners know that I'm working late. So we do have a draft of that. And so I'll be working with the staff to finalize that in the next couple of days. And then we'll get that out on the market, get it published in the newspaper that we're seeking advice and counsel on how to best properly dispose of that asset.
Okay.
And then the commission will have to choose who's the best qualified candidate to help us do that process.
All right. And I know there was some discussion yesterday, too, as what happens after you sell the items, where that money goes to.
Right. And as of right now, the commission want to maintain the flexibility of where we put those funds. And so that's good. I mean, it gives us the opportunity to, if we decide to put that money into one-time capital or just put it into reserves, that's an option as well. But it just creates the most flexibility for the commission. And that's what their choice was. And that's what we're going to do.
All right, Mike Breathorst, Becker County Administrator, joining me in the studio this Wednesday morning, talking about things going on in Becker County. Some of the other things that you're working on, some of the bigger projects, you got the County Highway Facility that has been the topic of much discussion in the recent months, and looking at building a new one. And I know you're in the process of maybe doing some tours of other facilities.
Right. There is a need out there, and the commission has acknowledged that need, that our highway department is it needs to be, you know, taken a look at very seriously and look at alternatives. And so some of these alternatives is actually a new facility. And so with that new facility, we're exploring everything from pole frame construction, steel frame construction, and concrete tip-up construction as well. And so the commission is doing some very strong due diligence here. We are going to be touring a couple other facilities in the area, in the Northwest region here, and just take a look at what these things look like and talk to their operators to see the life expectancy and the maintenance and what goes into maintaining these facilities. Because we want to do this right, and we want to do it right the first time. But we also want to be very fiscally responsible. And that's what our commission is very good at doing, is making the right decisions based on the information that they get. So, and that's what we're going to be doing here. I believe next week we have a couple of tours set up, and we've been welcomed to open arms from some of our partner communities here that have these facilities to say, come on over, check it out, and listen to our lessons learned.
All right. Very good. Yes. One of the great things about building a facility is actually showing it off, mm-hmm. which is what you will mm-hmm. be going around to look at. I'm in the studio this morning with Mike Breathorts from Becker County. He's the new administrator for Becker County, talking about things going on as we head into April, into May. Now you've got two April meetings under your belt. Some of the other things that were decided upon as of yesterday, the material recycling facility. Now there is an article about Polk County. I know that we toured Polk County a long time ago in Foston. They had what we have now, kind of, we thought it was the new technology, and, you know, they had the incinerator up there. I think it was, they were looking at the incinerator at Perm and, you know, that kind of thing. But we toured the Foston facility, but now they've kind of upgraded. And Becker County is looking to buy their equipment and right. update our facility.
Right. Garbage is a big deal.
It is.
And recycling is even a bigger deal, especially with the commodities and single stream revenue streams that the county can potentially recapture to reinvest back into our recycling program. So Becker County last year, 2018, I believe it was June, October timeframe, we opened up our MRF, mm-hmm. Materials Recycling Facility. I just like saying MRF, you know. And so we have a strong team out there, and we partner with Sentence to Serve. If people don't realize that, we work jointly on a volunteer program with our inmates through the state of Minnesota, and they come stay at our facility here, and then they, you know, learn skills and work skills, and we put them to work out at our recycling facility. Mm-hmm. And with that, what they're doing is on a daily basis, they are hand sorting the streams of waste that come into the facility on a conveyor belt. So there's guys literally standing over a conveyor belt and pulling out the plastics and the papers and the cardboards and so on. And so this new equipment is going to be an optical scanner, and also be able to go from, one of the estimates that I saw is right now we average about 0.75 tons. So 0.75 tons to 1 ton an hour. With this new equipment, we could go anywhere between, according to the manufacturer, that we could increase as high as 3 to 4 tons an hour. So, which would help us greatly in regards to the inflow and processing of this. Now, one of the other benefits of this is we're able to better separate out the materials. And because if we can separate out the materials and package that material, we can have better, get it to market better and get higher rates for that. And then to pay back this recycling cost that we incur to, you know, to maintain our environment. And so that's what we did yesterday, is we entered into an agreement with Polk County to buy their equipment, and which is a really high quality used equipment. And we also got state appropriations to help fund that through a grant. And so that we'll should be installing that within the next 90 days at the latest. So we're excited to see that going and increase the flow and maybe get some more aluminum cans out of there, or tin cans, and get higher returns on that. And that's why we're doing it, because we're being very fiscally responsible here and actually treating it like a business and making sure that we have the revenue streams to make to make up these costs.
Right. And if you want to talk more to people who are excited about garbage and recycling, Sandy Gunderson and Steve Skoog are the people that they do come on here once a month too at the beginning of the month and talk about that. And of course, the Household Hazardous Waste Facility is open today too to go and pick up goods if you need anything for free. So I'm in the studio this morning with Mike Breathorst from Becker County. He's the new administrator, and we're going to continue our conversation after a quick break. We'll be talking about Safe Routes to School proposal. You're working with Lake Park Audubon, also the Master Trail Plan, and more all ahead on HodgePodge this Wednesday morning.
The tobacco industry's business model. Step one, get them young. Nearly all smokers start by age 18. Step two, make them lifelong customers. Over half will die from smoking. Step three, find replacement smokers. Step four, repeat. Step one.
The tobacco industry will stop at nothing to get kids addicted. But if kids don't start, smoking stops. Learn how to help at stopthestartmn.com. Brought to you by Clearway Minnesota.
The news doesn't stop, and neither does the KDLM News team. You can count on KDLM News to be your number one source for local news in the Lakes area. And now you can count on KDLM News in your email inbox. That's more local news, weather, and information for the Lakes area delivered to you each day by our award-winning KDLM News staff. Go to KDLMradio.com to have our daily news headlines delivered to you. Powered by Swanson's Repair and Kubota of the Lakes.
This April at Shooting Star Casino Manoman and Bagley, get ready for a wave of excitement, a splash of big thrills, and a boatload of fun during our Catch and Cash giveaways with nearly $70,000 in cash and prizes. Play daily to win cash every Sunday up to $2,500. Then reel in the grand prize, $1,000 cash and a Sundrecker Bass Buggy Fishing Pontoon on Sunday, April 28th. We've got action that floats your boat. StarCasino.com.
Hey, watch this. From the three-point line. Nothing but net.
Oh, yeah, watch this. With my eyes closed. Swish.
Whoa, way to go.
This moment is brought to you by Anderson Brothers, where your driveway is more than just a driveway. It's a place for your kids or grandkids to make memories shooting hoops, playing hockey, or coloring with chalk. We are Minnesota's premier builder of driveways and parking lots. Call me, Tom White, today for a free quote at 346-6004 or visit us online at AndersonBrothers.com.
Do you like savings? OutletRecreation.com has the savings you want with no sales tax on all the fun stuff. It's the 4th annual Detroit Lakes Fun Fest happening April 19th through the 20th at the Freeman Hockey Arena. The largest inventory and all indoors. Motorhomes, campers, boats, pontoons, and more. Bring the kids for a bike giveaway and an Easter egg hunt. Don't worry, parents. We didn't forget about you. We'll pay your sales tax when you buy that day. That's up to 7%. DL Fun Fest. See website for details.
CBS News Update.
This has become a massive manhunt.
FBI agent Dean Phillips says police in Denver are searching for an 18-year-old woman who flew in from Miami Monday.
She departed the airport and went to a store where she did procure a weapon. She obtained a pump-action shotgun and ammunition.
He says Sol Pais is infatuated with the Columbine High School massacre, which took place 20 years ago this Saturday. Correspondent Barry Peterson is outside FBI headquarters in Denver.
Authorities knew they would face something like this week. They expected threats. This one they consider very, very credible. But they get threats all the time. Because of Columbine and because of the fascination with the shooting, they're very, very careful. They take them seriously. This one they have taken very seriously.
More than a dozen school districts in the Denver area are closed today as a precaution. CBS News Update. I'm Deborah Rodriguez.
The 4th Annual Celebrate Aging Expo, presented by Essentia Health, is Wednesday, May 15th at the Holiday Inn in Detroit Lakes. Come out for a day of fun, vendors and resource booths, samples, door prizes, seminars, entertainment, and more, all from 9 to 1 p.m. From 1 to 2, enjoy live entertainment from Louis Ronkin. His Do You Remember Buddy Holly tribute show will captivate and thrill. It's the 4th Annual Celebrate Aging Expo, Wednesday, May 15th at the Holiday Inn in Detroit Lakes. Brought to you by UCARE, Sunnyside Care Center, and Layton Broadcasting.
Hey, Hazel, have you seen that big, bright thing outside?
Oh, I think I know what you're talking about. The sun. I sure did. Makes everyone happy to see that thing outside.
Sure does. And you know what goes good with sunshine?
What's that, Elvira?
Monday through Friday, Shirley's 2-egg omelet with hash browns and toast for only $5.99, 7 to 11.
It sure does. Let's go.
Become a regular at Main Street Restaurant in downtown Detroit Lakes.
Now, back to HodgePodge with Carol McCarthy on KDLM Detroit Lakes.
Welcome back to HodgePodge this Wednesday morning, 17th day of April, 2019. Back in the studio with Mike Breathorst, the Becker County Administrator. And Mike, let's talk a little bit about some of the other partnerships that you're working on, partnering with Lake Park Audubon to work on a proposal for safe routes to school.
Yes, this is really exciting opportunity for everybody involved. But there's still some discussions yet that we have to go through and some approvals. But here's what we're trying to do is we are trying to, Lake Park Audubon has entered into a master plan for their trails network and their safe routes around their school district. And so with that, they are now eligible for something called the Safe Routes to School, capital grant. And so with that, we are partnering, the county is doing some county road improvements. Also, we are replacing some ADA ramps around the, in that general area. And so at that time, it may make sense for a partnership to occur between the city and the county to create a safer route to school and the state of Minnesota. And so we're looking for some, a partnership here to make this become a reality. And our total project costs, I have some numbers here for this. The total project cost is about $150,000 to do this project. And with this, the county's participation is right around, let's see here. We're asking for partnerships with Lake Park, with the city of Audubon, about around $5,000.
Okay.
And we're also looking for partnerships with the school district, about $5,000 to make this a reality. And then the county, we would chip in about $14,900. And then we also have some engineering preliminary construction design work, which is valued at $25,000. So, and then the state would come in with nearly a $100,000 grant. Mm-hmm. So, but this would definitely streamline and help improve that the travel and transportation for those people that live near and around the school district. The primary benefit is about a half mile from around the school and for those that live there. And so coming up next week, we have our meeting with the school district to see if they want to move forward on this.
Okay.
And so with our Master Trails efforts and our Safe Routes to School efforts, we think that it's a good time to move forward and see if there's a good partnership.
Right, yes. And I know both Detroit Lakes and Frazee have had grants. They received some grants for Safe Routes to School, and both communities enjoy safer routes to school around their area. And it was a great effort, great community effort.
It's interesting here, too. I'm looking at some of these statistics that we have in regards to a survey that was done relating to this program. And for people that live within the school district or within the half a mile, it said elementary schools within a quarter mile of the school. So it says Lake Park Audubon Safe Routes to School plans identified those children that attend elementary school within a quarter mile of the school, which I thought was really amazing. And then 50% walk to and from school. And of those who live within a half a mile of the school, 30% of those students walk or take their bike to school. So these are some big numbers. And then 82% of the students who live within a quarter mile of the school ask their parents for permission to walk to school. So this is just a program that we think to make it safer and healthier to be out there.
Right. All right. Mike Breathorst, Becker County Administrator, in the studio with me this morning. And since we're talking about trails, let's talk about Becker County's Master Trail Plan, which you are going to do some. What did you do yesterday? You actually got partnered with an organization to work up the plan?
That's exactly right. And also, so what we want to do is we're Becker County. What are we known for? Well, we're known for the lakes. We're known for the country here. We're known for the strong business culture that we have and the partnerships that we have. And so one of the guiding principles that our commission, every one of my five commissioners have told me that they have a desire to see improvements in our park and rec and trails. But we want to be smart about it. We want to be super smart about this. And so what we're doing is we are entering into a master trails plan phase, because without a plan, it just becomes hard. Mm-hmm. And it gets hard to secure funding. So that's what we're doing, is we entered into a contract yesterday with a vendor to help us with this master planning. And so we have a staff with Guy Fisher and our Becker County EDA and our Park and Recreation Board and EDA Board to help us with this master planning process. And we also have partners that have agreed to help us, like the Township of Osage. Osage contributed money to do this. Mm-hmm. They did not have to, but they did. And so that is absolutely just shows the strength of this plan and how it's being supported across the board.
Right. Yes. There's a lots of little trails out there. And, you know, Detroit Lakes has a lot of trails. And I know that the Heartland Trail, you know, is going to be worked on between DL and Frazee this year. So it is good to have kind of an overall plan for the area. And since Becker County is the large governmental unit mm-hmm. of the area, that's great that you're doing that undertaking. Some of the other things with outdoor recreation, I guess, you've got a dry dock lake outlet.
Yeah, this is another fun thing that we had going on here. Is several years ago, if you're familiar with the dry dock lake outlet channel, mm-hmm. So we have efforts that we're trying to do to improve that, to get that to restored to back the way it was. So I'm not as familiar with this particular project as I have not been on the site. But with our partnerships that we have developed so far, is that we have some fish weirs that we're going to be installing here to help with the erosion challenges that we have in the immediate area there. Mm-hmm. We also have a desire to enhance the fish passage that's currently been installed there. Fish passages are kind of a neat, unique design. You can actually see the fish jump and spawn up over these things. And that's what we're trying to do, is we're trying to stabilize this from deteriorating any more than it already has.
Okay.
And so we received a good size solid grant for this. Nearly $65,000 is the total project cost. And we got a grant of nearly $46,000.
Okay. And where is this actually located, the dry dock?
Well, I have the address.
Is that at the Dutton Locks?
It is at Dutton Locks area,
so
yes.
We know Dutton Locks. And I know that they're doing the walleye spawning right now, so that's great, and it's a great destination and a lot of heavily used area. So that will be great. So when would this start?
According to this document here, I think we're going to be starting within the next 60 days.
Okay,
we should see work start to move forward and get the contracts all assigned, and so by the end of the summer, I would anticipate it being completed.
Okay, so lots of projects underway, as it is a construction season everywhere, every corner of the state, county, and city. Mike Breathorst from Becker County in the studio with me this morning, administrator for Becker County. Some of the other things, Mike, of course, like most businesses around here, you've got a lot of job openings right now.
Oh my, yes, we do. We do. We're hiring. Uh-huh. Becker County's hiring. Okay. If you have a CDL license and you want to be do transit busing, we're hiring there. We have a custodian part-time maintenance position open. We have a full-time social worker behavioral health position open. Temporary boat and water deputies open. We have a transit dispatcher position open part-time. And then a zoning inspector. We have a zoning inspector, long-time zoning inspector that's worked with us. And he's announced his retirement.
Okay.
So we're trying to hold on to him as long as we can, because when you lose that institutional knowledge, it's hard. So,
right.
But if you know of anybody that does likes to do sewer inspections, that's the guy.
All right. So likes to be out in the field.
It is. Yeah.
All right. And then you've got a new transit bus in the works. I've seen our buses all over, and I've seen the new buses with the new decal on there, and they're making some headway around the area.
Yeah, this is great news too, because we have a bus that needs to be retired.
Mm-hmm.
It's getting old, and so we got a 100% grant to fund this new bus. We just entered into agreement to move forward on that here in the next couple of weeks. And so we will see that bus here. That won't arrive till probably the fourth quarter, just because of the speed of that process that we have to do to get that. But yeah, we're getting a new bus.
All right. Good news. And just a couple things to wrap up. A couple meetings have been rescheduled due to the weather and whatnot. Township meeting, the annual township meeting, is now on the 23rd.
Yes.
So next week. And that's at 7 p.m. at the courthouse.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And then the timber auction will be this Friday, and that was rescheduled.
Yeah. So if you're looking to buy some lumped timber, give us a reach out to Dan McLaughlin here at the county, and we'll be able to help you out. And it's a great program, that sale-in of that timber, because those profits that come into that help directly fund our parks program.
All right, great. And lots of this information is also found on Becker County's website. And Mike Breathorst, administrator for Becker County, thank you so much today for coming in.
Thank you, Carol.